Hi, I'm Brent Tharp, Agronomy and Product Manager at Wyffels Hybrids.
And I'm Steve Zobrist, the District Sales Manager at Wyffels Hybrids.
This is a great time to get ourselves prepared for the planting season because if you look at the calendar, it's not going to be too long before planters are going to start rolling.
Some of the things you might want to consider before heading to the field when checking over your corn planter is first your hitch height. When the row unit is down in the ground, you want to make sure your toolbar is level with the ground, parallel to the ground. Should roughly be about 20 to 22 inches off the ground. Make sure that your residue managers turn freely, that the bearings are in good working condition. One of the other things you might want to take a look at is if you're running a no-till coulter, you want to make sure that that coulter is at least running a quarter inch above the depth of your disc openers. As we move farther back, the disc openers themselves should roughly be, when they're brand new, they're 15 inches. If they wear down to about 14 and a half inches in diameter, they really should be replaced. You also want to make sure that the pinch point between the two disc openers is roughly an inch and a half to 2 inches to create a good V-trench for the seed. On your gauge wheels, you want to make sure that they are actually touching the disc opener. They should rub slightly to help keep that opener clean. If your corn planter has sprockets and chains, you want to make sure that those are all in good working condition. Keep them properly tensioned and that we don't have any links that are rusted. Any bad chains or vibration in the drive system will lead to erratic seed spacing.
You went through the planter checklist, and it's a great time, you know, on these cooler days to get this thing out in your barn lot or in your shop and get it unfolded and really look it over. But some other considerations as we get into planting, you know, guys in the past few years have pushed it, and they've actually went out there. You know, the general rule of thumb is don't start planting until the soil is 50 degrees, right? Well, guys have pushed that and they've got away with it in the past, especially the past few years. But we still have to remember, you know, the agronomist in me still says that seed has not changed as far as it still takes 50 degrees for it to germinate and for growth to occur. So 50 degrees is still an important mark. But really, what's more important is soil condition.
Correct.
Don't you think?
Yes, absolutely.
I mean, we do not want to mud in that crop, and we need that soil to be in really good condition when we decide to go out there and start planting.
So Brent, one of the questions I get every year from growers is, just to kind of set the stage, we might have an upcoming forecast that maybe isn't favorable, but yet the field is in perfect planting conditions. And I always get the question, should I be planting or should I wait?
Yeah, that's a tough question to answer, isn't it? I'd look at the forecast and I'd want to know what that forecast is, because if it is a forecast with heavy rains and it is cooler temperatures, maybe a cool down period coming out of a warmer period, I like to advise people to, you can keep on planting to about 24 to 36 hours before that event. I think you at least need 24 to 36 hours before that weather event comes in, because that first drink of water in that corn seed is very important. If it's too cold, you can do some damage to the seed structures. Steve, what's your recommended planting depth?
I like to plant corn at 2 inches.
2 inches is a great depth. You know, where have you run into more emergence problems or service calls over the years?
It's probably when you get into no-till conditions where the down pressure maybe is a little bit too light and that planter is riding up a little bit on a lot of that trash, and we don't get a good proper seed depth. And then when we don't get a good proper seed depth, if we're an inch and a half or shallower later on in the corn plant's life, those nodal roots will be developing above ground, and you can end up with obviously a weak plant. You won't get as much water and nutrient uptake versus if you're planting a little bit deeper at 2 inches, where we get those nodal roots to go down under the soil.
What's your minimum depth?
Minimum is 1 3/4 inches.
1 3/4 inches? Yeah. I think anytime you're under that 1 1/2, 1 3/4 inches, yeah, you're setting yourself up for potential issues for those nodal root development and those crown roots developing. If you would like more information on this or other agronomic topics, please visit the Wyffels.com webpage and click on the Agronomy tab. And have a great and safe planting season.